The Selma Marches, also known as the Selma to Montgomery Marches, were a series of peaceful protests and demonstrations that took place in 1965 in Selma, Alabama. The marches were part of the Civil Rights Movement, a decades-long struggle for equality and justice for African Americans in the United States. The background of the Selma Marches can be traced back to the history of racial discrimination and oppression in the American South. Despite the abolition of slavery in the 19th century and the passage of the 15th Amendment, which granted African American men the right to vote, many states in the South enacted laws and practices aimed at disenfranchising black citizens. One practice was the use of literacy tests and other discriminatory measures to prevent African Americans from registering to vote. In Selma, Alabama, for example, fewer than 2% of eligible black voters were registered in 1965. The lack of voting rights was just one aspect of the systematic racism and segregation that African Americans faced in the South. Schools, neighborhoods, and public facilities were often segregated, with separate facilities for black and white citizens. This was enforced by violence and intimidation by white supremacist groups like the Ku Klux Klan. In the early 1960s, the civil rights movement gained momentum, with activists using nonviolent protest and civil disobedience to draw attention to the injustices faced by African Americans. Selma became a focal point of this struggle, with local activists organizing demonstrations and protests to demand voting rights and end to discrimination. The first Selma March, also known as Bloody Sunday, was a pivotal event in the civil rights movement that took place on March 7, 1965. The march was organized by civil rights activists, including John Lewis, to demand voting rights for black Americans, who had been systematically denied the right to vote through discriminatory laws and practices such as literacy tests, poll taxes, and intimidation. Over 600 protesters began the march from Selma, Alabama, to Montgomery, the state capital. However, as the protesters attempted to cross the Edmund Pettus Bridge, they were met by a group of state troopers and local police who attacked them with tear gas, clubs, and bullwhips. The violent attack was captured by news cameras and broadcasted across the country, exposing the brutality of the Jim Crow South and galvanizing support for the civil rights movement. The violence of Bloody Sunday shocked the nation. The first Selma March was significant because it brought the issue of voting rights to the forefront of the civil rights movement and drew attention to the injustices faced by black Americans in the South. It also inspired others to join the movement and brought about changes in federal legislation.
Two of the most prominent organizations involved were the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, SCLC, and the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, SNCC. The SCLC, led by Martin Luther King Jr., was a prominent civil rights organization that focused on the nonviolent protest and civil disobedience to achieve their goals. The SCLC played a leading role in organizing the Selma marches and was instrumental in negotiating with President Lyndon B. Johnson for federal protections for the protesters. The SNCC was a student-led organization that also played a significant role in the Selma marches. The SNCC focused on grassroots organizing and nonviolent direct action to bring about change. The group played a key role in organizing the first Selma march and was on the front lines during the violent confrontation on Bloody Sunday. Police brutality during the first Selma March was a shocking display of violence and the oppression faced by black Americans in the South. The protesters were peacefully demonstrating for their right to vote and were met with excessive force by law enforcement. The use of tear gas and bullwhips on unarmed protesters was a gross violation of their human rights and an abuse of the power.
A man by the name of Jimmie Lee Jackson was born in Marion, Alabama in 1938. He grew up in a segregated society where African Americans were denied basic rights and opportunities. Despite this, Jackson was determined to fight for justice and equality. On February 18, 1965, Jackson participated in the first Selma March, a peaceful demonstration in Marion, Alabama. The demonstration was violently broken up by state troopers, and Jackson was beaten and shot by a state trooper. He died from his injuries just 8 days later. The life and involvement of Jimmie Lee Jackson in the Selma marches was significant, as his death was one of the catalysts that sparked the movement. His sacrifice and commitment to the cause of civil rights inspired many others to continue the fight for justice and equality. His legacy lives on, inspiring generations of activists and reminding us of the ongoing struggle for equality and justice.
Oh, freedom.
The second Selma March, which occurred on March 9, 1965, was known as Turnaround Tuesday. The march was planned as a continuation of the first Selma March, which became known as Bloody Sunday. However, before the second march could begin, a federal court order was issued preventing the marchers from leaving Selma. The court order was obtained by Alabama Governor George Wallace, who was fiercely opposed to the civil rights movement and determined to prevent the march from taking place. Despite the court order, the activists refused to give up. They held prayer and service and then began a symbolic march to the bridge, where they knelt in prayer and then turned around and returned to Selma. The marchers were led by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who had come to Selma to support the activists. The event was a powerful symbol of determination and resilience of the civil rights activists. Despite the setbacks and obstacles they faced, they refused to give up and continued to fight for justice and equality. The events of Turnaround Tuesday also drew national attention to the issue of voting rights in the South. The violence of Bloody Sunday had shocked the nation, and the peaceful symbolism of Turnaround Tuesday served to emphasize the importance of the cause and courage of those fighting for it.
Despite the violent attack on the first Selma March, King remained committed to the cause and helped to organize the second march from Selma to Montgomery. He played a crucial role in negotiating with President Lyndon B. Johnson and securing federal protection for the protesters, which ensured their safety during the march. King's impact on the Selma marches and the civil rights movement as a whole cannot be overstated. He was a powerful advocate for justice and equality and inspired millions of people around the world to fight for their rights. His legacy continues to be celebrated today and serves as a reminder of the ongoing struggle for civil rights and social injustice.
The third Selma March, or the March for Voting Rights, was a continuation of the first march and took place from March 21st to March 25th, 1965. After the violent attack on the first march, President Lyndon B. Johnson ordered federal troops to protect the protesters and negotiated with civil rights leaders to ensure their safety during the third march. The march began in Selma and covered a distance of approximately 54 miles to the state capital in Montgomery. Unlike the first march, the third march proceeded peacefully, with over 25,000 protesters joining the demonstration, including civil rights leaders such as Martin Luther King Jr., John Lewis, and James Bevel. The marchers carried banners and signs demanding voting rights and sang civil rights anthems such as "We Shall Overcome." On the day of the march, March 25, 1965, the protesters arrived in Montgomery and were met by a crowd of 50,000 supporters. Martin Luther King Jr. delivered his famous "How Long, Not Long" speech, expressing his optimism about the future of civil rights movement and urging his fellow protesters to continue their fight for justice and equality.
I know you're asking today, how long will it take? Somebody's asking, how long will prejudice blind the visions of men? I come to say to you this afternoon, however difficult the moment,
yes, sir,
however frustrating the hour, it will not be long,
no,
because truth crushed to earth will rise again.
Yes, sir.
How long? Not long.
Yes, sir.
Because no lie can live forever.
Yes, sir.
How long? Not long.
How long?
Yes, because you shall reap what you sow.
Yes, sir.
How long?
How
not long.
How long?
Truth forever on the scaffold, wrong forever on the throne.
Yes,
that scaffold sways the future.
Yes.
Behind the dim unknown standeth God within the shadow, keeping watch above his own. How long? Not long.
The march also led to an important change in federal legislation, including the passage of the Voting Rights Act of 1965, which prohibited discriminatory voting practices and ensured equal voting rights for Black Americans. The Third Selma March is remembered as a key moment in the struggle for civil rights and social justice and continues to inspire activists today.